No, we're out for sure. That lad is not well. Ask who's at left back. Does he not know? It's totally unacceptable. You know what that is? That stuff's just...
The people that were on were... Five, six, four...
Jen. Paulus, she's going to left back. Who's going to center midfield? Chrissy's going in here. And Brittany, okay. Wide on the right flank.
Okay.
Hold it back if you want to use it.
Okay, we're fairly close. Sorry. Okay, live, great, thank you. A lovely afternoon here this afternoon at Trent University with Trent Excalibur playing Laurentian. Their previous game at Laurentian. To Trent, but all the understandings that I've had about that match was that it was very, very close and... Hopefully, our team seemed to be up for today's game. They had a very good warm-up, and we seem to be under pressure immediately now. This is the keeper's ball for sure. Webb. Good idea. An opportunity, Julian, to win that. We won the second ball there. That won the ball. Oh, that's what I call a good high work rate. And the official again close to the play. We know that at Trent's training had some concerns about some illnesses and some injuries, and they've made some changes tonight just about that as well. The ball just off the bar, and Emily Webb was there. If ball had came down, I'm sure Emily would have got that. Count as winning balls, even winning the second ball, right? Yeah. somebody as long as you. That's an awful big shift. Is that getting a little cool, isn't it?
It's freezing.
Yeah. Lovely ball down the flank of the left flank. They haven't been in the habit of using the left flank. And that was one young Shannon O'Brien, who is really not feeling well too much during the week. Well enough to start this match today.
We think it was just a bit of a flu there. Mm-hmm.
I like the strikers playing off each other, but not too close together. Move into the space, especially diagonal running. Trying to play the ball down the right flank again. I'm not sure if they're going with 4-4-2 or not. Certainly three of the Trent team are deeper.
Mm-hmm. I think we're playing 4-4-2, but looks like the mids are pushing up.
They are playing 4-4-2. Yep. Oh, that's a good ball out. Headed out. Should have gone to the other flank. That's the diagonal running we were talking. We've been talking about in previous matches. It's obviously a good tactic. Very good tracking. Your time.
Yeah.
I played it off of the attacker for a Trent throw in. By the Laurentian player. Everybody seemed to stop there for some reason. And O'Brien's checked back. Where the distribution goes here. This is number 19, Jen Paulus, playing left fullback. And good tracking, but That's much better. Much better to make some space and draw the bottom line. Very nicely done. And we don't have a chance of. Lovely day here out at Trent University for the end of Trent.
Big weekend.
Big, big weekend, yes. And we had a lady here.
Oh, I don't want to butcher her last name.
She gave a nice nice talk to the players.
Try and inspire us, yeah.
Yes, very, very nice young lady. Mm-hmm.
It was cool. She brought her silver medal. We got to hold it.
Yes, yes, silver medal. Now, there's no width on either side of the pitch.
Yeah.
What's happened here?
Kelsey on number 7 right now.
Wow. Oh, that's a good idea. Good ball. It's a great idea. Well done, Shannon O'Brien. Well done.
Wow.
Well, that was close to being still in. Oh.
They're giving it to us.
Well, that's a good thing.
Yeah.
Is it a throw-in? Obviously, by the look as he's holding that up there.
Yeah.
Well, someone should be showing in the middle. We have too many, far too many in the gap there. Oh, that's a great run.
Yeah.
That's a. Who is that young lady there at right fullback? Ella DiNardo.
Yeah.
That's a very good anticipation where the ball's going. She read that very well. I think we commented on her in previous. Yeah.
She's
excellent.
Third year player,
yep. Yeah. Looks like the Wrench should have 7 first-year players. I don't believe that too many of them are on the pitch right now. I see. I hear the staff over there yelling, now, what? Seven first-year players. Commented that's a good, good outlook for. Far too deep in our own end.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's
keeper should be calling for that. Keeper really should be calling for that. Oh, she's just instructed to get the ball out. Well done. Now, one of these two strikers have to drop. One of those two strikers. Someone should be out on the D. Excellent. One of our players should really be on the D, and that's where Shannon's going right now. Good. Very nicely read. And I would shade my lone striker even a little deeper, too. That behind the goal, that was kind of wasted, wasn't it?
Didn't even go in.
Only good thing about that is we didn't do it.
We intimidated them.
Yes. Looks like a nice crowd here this afternoon. But a lot of them sitting in the shade. I don't know why they would do that. You must stretch out, ladies. You must stretch. So much, Samantha.
Mandarin.
Oh, he's got a call for. The ball's on our left.
Yeah.
Right now, I would say possession-wise, we're probably 50, a little percent to Laurentian and perhaps 47-46% Trent. Control.
Oh.
Drop.
Enough of fighting.
I don't think they really need a wall here. At least certainly not a big wall. Deep. Shannon's even going deep. Number 12, Shannon O'Brien. So it looks like they've said that central striker, really.
Oh, yeah.
And she reads the ball very well.
Yep.
And oh, this is the time. Don't like this. Crack that wide player. Who came on for Catherine Munro?
Danielle Curdy.
Danielle Curdy.
Mm-hmm. Number 8.
Number 8. So she came on here.
Yeah,
that's twice I think we've had the bar hit. Oh. And it's much closer to man-to-man marking now, for sure.
Yeah.
Space doesn't score goals. People do.
Right in front of that.
Keeper? Well done. Well held by Emily Webb. Nicely done. And good, quick distribution off to the flanks. 2v3 there, but that's okay. Better than the ball in our back third. Oh, I like that quickly in there. That's lovely stuff.
like Chrissy, number nine, Chrissy Boyles, is pushed to outside right mid.
Chrissy's gone to, that's where she normally starts.
Yeah.
Chrissy Boyles normally starts.
Curdy's taking center mid.
And Curdy's gone to center midfield. Well, that's a normal lineup for them anyway, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Danielle's gone to central midfield in a defensive role, I think. This is almost 3v3 in the middle. Mm. And look at the support this number 10 is making, a support run. Number 10. Celine.
Valiquette.
Looks like a nice little player in midfield for Laurentian. Read that situation very well. This is still too much too big a shift. I really think it is. They haven't shifted that far. If you see, they're at least 15 meters wider than we are. I don't think anyone's going to get that.
There are two main scorers, are number 9 and number 2.
9 and 2?
Yeah.
So, number 9.
Lisa Watson.
Yeah. That's a central striker. We don't have a starting lineup for this team. And number 2 would be Julie Lopez. Two strikers for Laurentian. They seem to have a good understanding with each other. I like this marquee in the back. Still have a free player in the middle. That's always good. And there she goes. Right in to win the ball. Very nicely done. Excellent. And the ball to the flank. And I do believe she tried to put that to the middle. And again, the darn roll of that ball. But their idea was perfect. Yeah. The idea was great. Excellent. I think O'Brien reads the game very well. But both strikers are far too close together. Far too close together. Makes it so easy for defenders to mark them. Sam Mandarano has taken up a position wide. Get there first if you can. Get that a girl well in. And that's what immediate pressure does. It makes the defenders get rid of the ball so very quickly. Mm-hmm. And we've won a throw-in very deep in the Laurentian end. Jen Paulus taking this throw-in.
O'Brien's
down injured. That's not a good thing. She's a tough little devil, that young lady.
She is.
So she's...
Looks like she might have... got the wind knocked out of her.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. But she seems moving well. It doesn't seem to be a muscle injury or anything like that. So, all right. So many players close to the ball, though.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost like we discussed in previous games that halfway line is like perhaps I better not say the Berlin Wall. I'm not familiar with that one, but... The Great Wall of China sort of thing. And look at the work right here. That's excellent. That's very, very... Oh, this is a nice little player. This is the young lady we just mentioned.
This is number 7.
Number 7. That's what happens when you try and do too much. And look at the mark back by O'Brien. That's excellent work. Great. Little devil goes in, doesn't she? Well done.
Really important.
Well done. Lay it back. Good girl. Pick out where you want it. Excellent. Go on, Shannon. Go on, girl. Go on. Oh, both strikers going for this. Excellent. Both Carly Donwoody and Shannon O'Brien going for that ball. O'Brien running at the defenders. First time out.
Yeah, trying to break
That's
through.
It. Get close. Very close and quickly. Very close and quickly. Well done. Trying to move the ball out. That's a good, very good understanding. I like that. And lay the ball back for support. And a big one down the middle.
Oh.
I don't like 3v3 in the back. I don't like that at all. Well done. Well done. That's courageous. Very well done. Get stuck into head balls. Excellent.
Yeah. Again, you know. That's Kelsey White. It's her first year playing center D.
That's well done. I think that's a white ball. Yes, well done. Sometimes it helps to put your arm up. Influence, it's called.
Yeah.
Now look at the throw this ball so we can get. I would definitely drop a defender. Pull that one. If we drop the left or the center back into an open position, it would draw the striker back there, and she could throw it flat across this pitch.
Yeah, create some space.
Mm-hmm. Pressure. No. That's not pressure. That's pressure. Oh, well back, Shannon O'Brien. Very well back. Oh, look at the huge gap in midfield.
Mm-hmm.
That's monstrous. Oh, and she's ran that ball out very well. Which one is that? What number is that?
That's Natalie Selkirk.
Natalie Selkirk?
Number 7.
Yes, I like her. She's she reads the game very, very well back there. Good high work rate. Get the heck out of there, ladies. They are a little deeper than they have been in the past, but only a few yards, not so many.
Yeah.
Uh-oh, that's too high and wide. Resolute defending. I'm not sure if there's a second game here this afternoon or not with the men's team.
Yes, there is.
There is? Good, yep. good. What a lovely afternoon for that.
And a lacrosse game later this evening.
And a lacrosse game later this evening.
Men's lacrosse. It's a big weekend for sports.
Yeah. Well done. Get to it. And look, I love that.
See,
her head went up, and she wanted to push that ball to the middle. Again, a diagonal run would have been extremely helpful there. Get the space wide. Oh, that's good work. That's excellent. Strike it if you can. Get to it if you can. Go in and win it. Go on. Go in and win it. Atta girl. Get tight. Atta girl. Well done. Get really tight. Get back there, too. Don't stand off. Get stuck in.
There we go.
Oh, that's a good ball wide. Hey, I think Trent's... I really honestly think Trent's improving every time I see them. They really are. They're getting so much better. Small increments, but still getting better.
Well, we're doing so much better than last year, you know.
Yes, they are. They really are. And the future, as we've said so many times, with so many first-year players.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-oh. See, actually, Shannon there was facing the ball, was very nice.
Yep.
But if she had tried to move to space so that the other striker come into the space she just left,
mm-hmm.
that would have been... I would train at that, actually, those two strikers. One shifts the defender out of the way, so that the other one can move into that gap that she's just left.
Yeah.
We have some young gentlemen here.
The men's team coming in.
Yeah. Look at that work rate. Oh, and that's a lovely, lovely ball.
Yes.
What good vision she has. And that's an excellent ball to the right flank. Push up. The right fullback should be pushing up now to support that play. You see how they're dropping back?
There.
Yeah.
Yep.
where's he called that? A corner. Yeah. Excellent. Nice. See how many we send here. Only leaving 1v1 here in the back. No, two now. But she should attack that space. Oh, standing there waiting for it. Remember, it's players that score goals, not space.
There you go. Right in the box.
Go on. I think another corner.
Corner.
Yes, another corner. Excellent. That's from the pressure of O'Brien.
Mm-hmm.
They're just hesitating, or I should say leaving a little bit too early. Maybe just 2 seconds or 1 second even. Mm-hmm. They're already arriving and slowing down their pace by the time the ball gets there. They should be arriving with pace to knock it. Uh-oh. Oh. Tell me that, Shannon. Oh, and good support. Fullback supporting. Well done.
I hear them calling for it.
Yeah. Last player. Away, away, away.
I think they'll play keeper.
Yes, great stuff. Great stuff. Boom, boom, boom. Whoa!
Oh,
Kels. Oh.
Yeah.
Oh. Excuse me. Oh.
That's it.
Oh.
The fans are going crazy.
Heavens. Heavens to Murgatroyd.
Oh.
Lucky, lucky,
Give
lucky.
It's a heart attack.
Oh. Throat lozenges.
Yeah.
Good for you. Maybe the luck's with us this afternoon.
Yeah. We got luck of head of the trip.
Mm-hmm. Oh, some good movement there. Good ball movement. Oh. Offside. Oh, halfbacks have to get tighter to people.
Yeah, half minutes.
You can't let those players get goal silent. Get in. Get stuck in. Away. That's a safe ball. It's well done. And the strikers move to the flank. Very nice. I'd say we've been...
Looks like 45 seconds left.
Ah, I don't think we've had any stop. Well, we did have one short stoppage when O'Brien
Shannon
went down, yeah.
So maybe a little bit of time there.
Mm-hmm. I don't like our sweeper marking anyone. I really don't like that at all.
Yeah.
Had a girl. Oh, easy. Oh, huh? Keep body behind the ball. Get up, get up. We're so close together. There's two or three girls going for the same ball.
Mm-hmm.
And one player can mark 4 or 5 players if they're that close together.
Yeah.
Which only indicates that they've got players open somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
That's a handball.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's calling it.
I think the referee just had a glance at his watch.
Yeah. They should definitely be nearing the end soon.
Mm-hmm. Have you noticed that the ball's on the right flank still, much more than on the left flank?
Mm-hmm.
Well done. That's great. Great work. Worth the effort. Now, see if the distribution's off to our left.
Going to switch it.
The fullback number 3 is shown here. She's hammered it down the middle.
Uh-oh.
Don't like that too much.
Good cover.
Away with it. Away with it. Away. That's a girl. Oh, what a... Uh-oh.
Oh, Jen looks a bit injured.
Uh-oh.
It's like her ankle. That's Jen Paulus, number 19.
Jen Paulus. Seemed to have a ankle or foot problem somehow.
Her ankle. She had a head injury last game as well.
Did it turn into a concussion?
It was, I believe, player elbowed her in the head. Actually, she was bleeding a bit.
It's Candace Thomas, the trainer. Mm-hmm. Brian's coming off, Paula's coming off here. And they've got a huddle going. I have no idea what that conversation would be. The instructions really should be are coming in now from the bench.
Yeah, we sent Emily Larkin.
Emily Larkin will play left fullback for sure.
She's a lefty.
Yeah. I believe I've commented on Emily in the past. Mm. I thought she was great. I thought she was a center midfielder.
Yeah.
But Joe said that Coach Joe Muldoon said that he had tried her there and it wasn't too successful. But I'm not sure if they had actually trained her in midfield.
Yeah.
It makes a heck of a difference for sure.
Definitely, if you train them or not.
See how close the strikers are?
Yeah.
There we go.
Shannon taking
it. Oh, that's great stuff. Oh, and that's
nice.
A lovely first-time ball.
Nice.
Strike it if you must.
Yeah. And number 22 is a really great strike,
too. They need help from the back, not front. That's where they need the help from, right there. Well in. Well done. Which young lady is that?
Number
11. Excellent.
Kayla DiNardo, our right.
DiNardo? Player. Excellent.
Oh, trying to play it back.
Oh,
there.
We're going through the middle here. Just keep your eyes on the ball. Keep your eye on the ball. Keep your eye on the
Just
ball.
Keep with
don't,
it.
Don't look anywhere else. Look on the ball. Look at the ball. That's it. Get in, win it. Atta girl. Down the flank. Come on, Shannon. Make the move. Atta girl. That's well done. That's extremely well done. When people are running at you with a ball, you must never take your eye off the ball. Look at their hips if you want to, but keep your eye on the ball.
Yeah. Adding a lot
nice.
Of time.
Oh, good that. Idea. Really, really good idea. That was Danielle Curti,
mm-hmm.
number 8. Well done, Danielle. She was trying to do the right things there. She was trying to get the ball to the flank and to the white shirts. I see that left arm of the lines person has gone up again. In. Had a girl. Well done. Well done. Well done again. Oh, I think that's a goalkeeper's ball. I think so. Yeah. We have a mascot down here, all dressed in green. Good for him.
Good for him.
Cool. That's first time out of the back. I love that.
Mm-hmm.
Go on. Go on. Atta girl. Excellent. Now the halfback should go over her. What she's doing. Excellent.
Yeah.
Get in. Get in. Win it there. Oh, look at the cover. That's great cover. Well done by Natalie Selkirk.
Mm-hmm.
Very, very good cover. I like her too. She's a good one.
She's a great defender.
Mm-hmm. But we don't want to give any away in the first half, no.
No, definitely not.
Go into the second half, John, and become a second half team.
Yeah. We're a really great first half team.
Well, I'm sure the staff will talk to them at the halftime.
Oh, yeah.
We're never really sure what to do to start the second half. To just go right at them would be my advice. Get stuck into them really early.
Get
the balls out wide and terrorize them, really.
Yeah. Oh, we've got the stands packed full.
That's excellent, isn't it? A reflection of Head of Trent, of course. But
of course.
I like the way this Shannon O'Brien drops back deeper into almost into midfield so that she can pick up the ball.
Just gets right a great,
great. Oh, that lovely. Oh, flag. I'll have a word with that linesman.
Referee's assistant.
They're not bad, really.
You want me to...
Only if you need it, though. Oh, you did.
Yeah.
Good. Caught good girl. I really like this sweeper here. Open position, and that's the end of the first half with its score tied 0-0. And pretty even match so far. We have some demonstrators going out on the pitch. They're out on the sideline here. So well done, Laurentian and Trent University. And we'll be back for the second half. Good. And we're about to begin the second half of the ladies' Trent Excalibur and Laurentian. It's nil-nil at the half. And both teams with a couple of good opportunities. Actually, particularly Laurentian had some hit the post and hit the crossbar twice. So I just hit the crossbar twice, hit the post once. We're started again into the second half. And we're pressing here, I think. Goal kick for Laurentian. As I've mentioned in previous broadcasts, Trent has progressed considerably, in particularly in, now that looked very close to an offside position, however, well done, well, a very nice save. Trent University, Excalibur have become much quicker at marking players. It's extremely important that we don't allow opposition players time on the ball. So the one thing that players dislike more than anything else is lack of time. They like to be creative on the ball, and the more pressure you put on, the sooner you put it on them, the better your team's going to be. And Jillian Fraser has just rejoined us. How did the conversation go at halftime?
Good huddle, yeah.
Good.
Was it talking?
How were the instructions at halftime?
I talked about pushing out more for Emily's kicks. Since they always usually hit about the hash mark.
Mm-hmm.
Talking about making some more diagonal runs with the,
excellent,
with the strikers there and having an outside mid kind of support when they're right out at the box there.
Mm-hmm. Good, good, good. That sounds like awful good information to me. Of course, that's a very experienced staff, so this should be good information.
Yeah. It's always the first 20 of the second half is always
actually
most important to us.
You see that ball there?
Yep.
First thing is just knock it back down the same flank, and we have our number 9 here, who is, where's your Chrissy Boyles?
Mm-hmm.
On the right flank here,
yeah.
Wide open, and how are you doing? You get that okay, son?
Yeah.
All right, there you go. There you go. We're getting tangled up in with our feet with the wires here. I've always been a fan of Chrissy Boyles, by the way.
Always?
Oh, yes. A good little player.
Oh, yeah. In her fifth year of eligibility.
Oh, yes, yes.
She's a tough player.
Very
rugby.
Experienced. Perhaps that's why I like her, because she's experienced.
Yeah.
And a good ball down the flank. Mm-hmm. And quite prepared to make a diagonal run here. That's Carly Dunwoody, number 21. Mm-hmm. Excellent. Get in and win it, girls. Get in and win it. Yeah, well, she only pulled her back with one arm.
Right to the keeper.
That's great. That's good. Good sure hands. Soft hands. See if we win this.
Oh.
No, it didn't win it. We have to be more assertive, perhaps.
We noticed Laurentian's back line really like sending those long balls to the strikers.
Mm-hmm. Right down the middle.
Trying to cut those off.
The space between the two strikers is a little more this half, which I feel is good. Oh, first time to the ball. You can't beat that with a stick. I love that kind of thing. Uh-oh. Nearly in behind. A good understanding between those two young ladies, though.
It's like offside call.
Tried to head it through knowing full well that the white player was coming inside.
Mm-hmm.